the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God will walk with me down streets where no one else will walk. God will talk with me about things of which no one else will talk. When no one else will walk, and no one else will talk, when no one will, God will.
For our Goodnight message on this Tuesday, the 2nd of February 2021, the Feast of the Presentation of Our Lord, broadcasting from the Salesian Pontifical University, Rome, Italy, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. We listen to this encouraging message entitled, "The Lord You Seek Will Come."
Talk with me when friends forget and fail to understand.
This message of encouragement is based on the word of God we are today, taken from Malachi chapter 3, verse 1 to 4, connecting it to the gospel passage of today. The last book of the Old Testament is Malachi, which lists the serious charges the Lord had against backsliding Israel and the judgment that must inevitably fall on his errant people. It condemned their sacrilegious offerings and pronounced judgment on the wicked because of their gross apostasy, serious idolatry, and shocking denial of God's holy character. But it is also a book of hope. That is why I'm able to talk about it in the Goodnight message. As you know, the Goodnight messages are meant to give us hope. It is a book of hope that proclaims restoration for a faithful remnant, prophecies of the coming Messiah, and implores God's people to be obedient to His word and to look for the coming of Elijah, who was to be the forerunner of God's anointing King. "Behold, I'm going to send my messenger," is the encouraging proclamation at the start of chapter 3. "Be ready," is the watchword. "I'm about to send my herald who will clear the way before me." God was telling his faithful remnant that one day he would send a man to be a voice in the wilderness. He was to come in the spirit and power of Elijah and cry out, "Prepare the way of the Lord in the wilderness. Make a straight highway for our God in the desert." The Israelites were to repent of their sin and welcome their king. Although 400 years would have to pass before John the Baptist became that lone voice, crying out in the desert and preaching the baptism of repentance for the remission of sins, he was to be God's final witness to Israel before the Lord whom the nation sought would suddenly come to his temple, the feast we celebrated today. When Malachi was preaching to the people, many of them had given up hope. They thought God was not going to come and attend to their needs. They thought God was not going to act. God may be slow to act, but he will surely act. We may be looking at the situation we face today and wondering, is God going to come in the temple, the God we seek? Is he going to act? We are seeing so many things happening. We are seeing denial in the things that are affecting our lives. But one thing we have to know is that God will come through. He is the one we seek, that is going to come through as he came into the temple through the Blessed Virgin Mary and Joseph, presented in the temple. He is going to show His presence in our lives as the Emmanuel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.
God will care for me whenever there is no one else to care. When no one will be there. Forget and fail to understand. God will strengthen me when I am weak and need a help.